Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to see stored procedure in MySQL. First of all, we will see stored procedure in brief. Stored procedure in MySQL. There are two type of storage routine. One is stored procedure and stored function. But today we are going to see only stored procedure. Stored procedure are executed in the database MySQL, and it is called by language like Java, PHP, C Sharp. When to use stored procedure? We put a code and we run call command to call the stored procedure. We should avoid putting things like inline as is much necessary. Means we have to decide, probably have to decide when to use stored procedure, when to not use stored procedure. That is, it is like creating API to your database. Now we will see actually the execution of stored procedure. Yes, stored procedure is executed. Now we will call that. Total students are 4 and procedure is executed for ID name student having, here we will see, student having total marks greater than 70. So there are 3 students having mark greater than 70. We will see actually the table. Okay, now we will see the Java code. Import java.sql.star, load all the packages which are required for database connectivity, load the driver, then class name Java PROC, then public. In the sense, method is public. Static means method will be executed before creating any object. Void means that method doesn't return anything. Main means the name of that function. String args in the sense, in Java everything is treated as string. Throws means exception. When you write throws, you doesn't need to write catch statement. Then class for name. Registered the driver for driver manager, then connection call driver manager. This is the connection string for database connectivity to the MySQL database, and it creates a process with the help of which you can connect to database. That means application can have multiple JDBC driver connecting simultaneously. Then statement, then call dot create statement, used to create statement. Then result set, it is used to represent result set in the database query. Now we will actually execute the code. Yes, three names are there. Thank you.